Alabama is always producing star defensive linemen, but the subject of today's video had no chance of becoming an NFL superstar. I mean, he didn't even play football until his senior year, he was a two-star recruit, and he was originally committed to a lower-level college football program. Instead, in a matter of 5 games, he got one of the most prestigious offers in all of football, became a superstar for the Crimson Tide at the highest collegiate level, and is now a potential Defensive Rookie of the Year candidate in the NFL. In today's video, we're going to talk about the incredible story of Christian Barmore, how all of this happened, and why he is about to take over the NFL. But right before we get into it, nearly 80% of you guys are not subscribed to the channel, so quickly be sure to do that, smash that like button for the algorithm, and turn on post notifications so you never miss when I upload. Now, let's talk about Christian Barmore. Going back in time, Christian Barmore grew up as an athlete, but he did not take a liking to football at first. He actually grew up loving the sport of basketball, and when he got to Delaware Valley Charter High School in Philadelphia, that's the sport that he was a star at. That wasn't until the head football coach convinced Barmore to join the football team. Unfortunately though, by the time 2017 had rolled around, the charter school had closed due to financial issues, so he decided to transfer to a different high school. At the time, Barmore was 6'4", 290 pounds, and this would be his first time stepping on the football field. Going back a little bit to that summer, his coach had taken him to a Temple Owls football camp, and the staff immediately knew they found a gem. I mean, they literally offered him on the spot, and he had not even played football yet. His coach said, quote, "Temple wanted to keep it quiet. They didn't want anyone else to know about this hidden gem." After just a few games, he became a two-star recruit, the number 48 player in the state of Pennsylvania, and the number 2077 player nationally. Not exactly someone who's going to be taking over the NFL. Eventually, Barmore also received offers from Buffalo and Morgan State, and then schools such as Maryland and Oregon started to go after him. Some analysts saw Christian as an offensive guard, but when he switched to defensive line, that's when everything broke out for him. He had a unique blend of size and athleticism, and he was apparently a monster on the field who could disrupt from both sides of the ball. Either way, the dude was extremely talented. His high school coach said, quote, "I've never in person experienced a kid with that kind of God-given talent. We've coached kids up who've become great players and went on to college, but to experience him firsthand, it was something special." His coaches tried to get the SEC involved, but there was initial skepticism and there was a roadblock. Typically, the SEC starts recruiting kids when they're sophomores or junior in high school, but at this point, the guy had only played in a couple games, it was his first year of football, and he was a senior. There was a lot of skepticism, but eventually they would cave in. His high school coach called up an old buddy by the name of Mike Loxley, who at the time was the defensive coordinator at Bama, and told them to take a look at Barmore's film. Immediately, they tried to bring him in on a visit, and Barmore would visit Tuscaloosa, and head coach Nick Saban and the staff all agreed that he deserved an offer if everything checked out when they saw him. That's exactly what happened, and he was dominant on both sides of the ball. One scout said, quote, "He would explode off the line of scrimmage and even change the line of scrimmage and handle you like nobody's business. Every play from that nose guard position, he would pursue the football like he was a middle linebacker. He was a man amongst boys." Bama's defensive line coach eventually came to visit him. In 5 games into Christian Barmore's entire football career, he had a commitment from Nick Saban, and now he was committed to the Tide. His dream of playing for them had literally come to fruition in less than 2 months. His high school coach said, quote, "When he visited Alabama, he fell in love with it. He felt that it was the best place for him. Him and his mother also loved everything the school had to offer." He had dominated in the high school football system, but it's crazy he almost stayed with basketball. 24/7 Sports would eventually have to eat their words, as Barmore went from a 2-star recruit and ranked not even inside the top 2,000 to a 4-star recruit, the number 16 defensive tackle, and the 176th best player in the class of 2018. He was ready to go to his dream school at Alabama, but how would he do against SEC-level competition? When he arrived at Alabama, there was obviously a lot of talent and players around him, so he was not going to see the field as a freshman. Because of that, he assigned to redshirt, and in 2018, the Tide would go on to have a good year. 2019 is when Barmore would finally see the field, as he registered his first stat against New Mexico State, helped them beat South Carolina, and had a career game against Southern Miss. He would get his first career sack against Texas A&M, have a sack in their loss to LSU, and also help them beat Mississippi State. Finally, after a great game against Auburn, he was named the Defensive Player of the Week for Alabama, and had a great finish to the regular season. The Tide had lost both LSU and Auburn, so they had to settle for Michigan in the Citrus Bowl, and they ended up killing the Wolverine. As a redshirt freshman, Barmore had 26 total tackles and 2 sacks, but he was a force on the line, and because of that, he was named the SEC All-Freshman Team. The sky was seemingly going to be the limit for him in 2020, but would he put it all together? Going into 2020, the world was in a little bit of a weird spot, and so was college football. Alabama was also in a weird spot, as people said they were falling off after they had gotten blown out by Clemson 2 years ago and had missed the playoff in 2019. Well, Barmore and the Tide would go on a mission in 2020, and he became one of the best defensive linemen in all of football. He didn't end up playing until the Ole Miss game, as in what was a thrilling game against Lane Kiffin, the Tide ended up winning 63-48. The following weekend against Georgia, Barmore would have another sack and help them beat the number 3 Bulldogs. He'd remain relatively quiet throughout the next 3 weeks, as during that time frame they would beat Tennessee, Mississippi State, and Kentucky. He'd finally get back and get a sack against number 22 Auburn, and then in a road matchup with LSU, he had both a sack and a forced fumble. At this point, Barmore was having a spectacular year, and he would finish the regular season even better, as he had 2 sacks and a road win over Arkansas. Because of that, the Tide went undefeated and were headed to the SEC Championship game. In what was a thriller against the number 7 Gators, Kyle Trask had Florida in it, but Barmore forced a fumble and helped the Tide win 52-46. From there, they would go to the college football playoff, where against Notre Dame, Barmore would have 5 tackles and a sack, and then in the national championship game against Ohio State, he'd have 5 tackles and a sack once again. He ended up becoming an All-American, an All-SEC player, and one of the most disruptive linemen in the country after he finished with 37 tackles, 8 sacks, and 3 forced fumbles. Because he'd already played 3 years, he was eligible for the 2021 NFL Draft, and he decided to declare. Barmore would end up becoming the top interior lineman in the 2021 NFL Draft, and the Patriots would trade up to take him with the 38th overall pick in the second round. He apparently had made waves during the offseason, and he was going to have an impact in 2021 for the Patriots. So far, Barmore has made an impact. In 11 games played so far, he's pretty much started all year, has 26 tackles, half a sack, and Pro Football Focus is all over him. As the weeks have gone on, Barmore has gotten better and even more dominant. It seems like he's learning how to play, he's blossoming into a star in front of our eyes, and everyone keeps talking about how he's going to be one of the next big things. It's crazy to think that 5 years ago, he had barely ever stepped on a football field and was only a 2-star recruit. He then went to Bama and is now a star for arguably the most successful NFL franchise of the last 20 years. I guess all that natural talent worked out for him, and I'm a big fan of Christian Barmore. What do you guys think though? Who is your favorite Alabama defensive lineman ever? Who has another great story from the 2021 class? And what do you think of Christian Barmore's potential? Be sure to let me know down in the comment section. Smash that like button for the algorithm, and check out all my other videos on the end screen, including my video about what happened to Blake Barnett. I hope to see you guys again soon, but until next time, peace.